Hi, this is James Cook of the University of Maine at Augusta, and this is the first video in a series that is showing you how to take a small, cheap computer called a Raspberry Pi and use it for social media data mining and analysis. Now, the Raspberry Pi is a really tiny, really inexpensive computer. And this is what it looks like. This is a Raspberry Pi 2. It's the most advanced Raspberry Pi that they have going around, and it costs a little bit more than $30. You can get a Raspberry Pi that will do most of the same things that we're going to do in this series, called the Raspberry Pi Zero, for a mere $5. But we're going to work with this one today. In order to get this computer to work, you're going to need a little bit more than a mere board. You're going to need some memory, something called NOOBS, new out-of-box software, a micro USB drive right here, not the big one, the little one. You're going to need possibly a case to keep everything from getting damaged. If you want to communicate to the internet, you're going to need something called a USB dongle. Believe it or not, this little tiny thing can connect you to the network if you have a Wi-Fi network, which I'm going to assume you have. You're going to need a power supply. You'll need a mouse and a keyboard. And each of these elements can be purchased for something around $10. And you're going to need to hook up to some kind of monitor. Now, most modern TVs have an HDMI slot. That's what we're going to hook up with today. There are other solutions that are out there. You can look them up on the internet. They're a little more complicated. HDMI is very simple. There's an order for connecting your gear once you have it all set up. The first thing you need to do is you need to take this micro SD card out of its box. Not the big one, but the little one. This little chip here has 8 gigabytes of memory on it, and it's the size of my smallest digit. And it's really hard to find the slot for it, but it's on the bottom, and it's hidden right there, right underneath this bit here. Okay, you have to look around for it, but I'm going to insert that in very gently and wait for it to click. And it's in. That was it. There's your installation of memory. How could it be simpler? Well, you could have a mouse. It should be a USB mouse, a mouse with a USB cable. The Raspberry Pi has 4 USB slots. So let's insert the mouse. And now you notice I'm holding this by the edges. I don't want to touch the actual circuits. And there it clicks in. I'm going to do the same thing for the keyboard cable, and I'm doing this at home because this is a home project, really, right? You can now do data mining at home. Now we have a mouse and a keyboard. The next thing we're going to want to hook up is a video cord. So I'm going to go over onto the side of my TV, and I'm going to look for the HDMI slot. I'm going to hook it in there, and then I'm going to find the HDMI slot here. Fortunately, you'll notice there's lots of little writing. There's an actual label that shows you where the HDMI slot is, right here. I'm going to plug that in. This is what they mean by plug and play, right? What could be simpler? The last thing I need to do is to take my power. And I should only have that hooked up when everything else is ready. Okay. Now for later installments, you'll see my Raspberry Pi in a case, all protected, but I wanted you to see the innards today. Okay. And now this is the same kind of power source that would run a typical non-Apple phone, and you'll see there's a source for power in there. So I'm going to put that very carefully in. All right. Now, you notice I've got a little signal there. And boom, I've got Raspberry Pi loading and an installation. In our next video, we're going to take a look at how to log in for the first time, and it's actually quite simple.